Alright guys, today we're doing Calvin Harris featuring Florence Welch, Sweet Nothing. And I just saw an animated version of this, a piano lesson, and you know, it's just, nothing replaces a real teacher. You can put all of the technology, yeah, maybe they'll come up with something eventually that does, but nothing replaces a real one-on-one teacher, and the next best thing is a video lesson that's one-on-one. So that's what I'm going to do for you here. We're looking at this middle line here. All right, so we have something like this. And then we have later. And, you know, the most satisfying thing, though, is just playing these chords here. All right, playing the melody along with it just doesn't really sound right on the keyboard for this type of music. So I would recommend just playing these chords along with the song for fun. So let's learn what the chords are. B, D sharp, G sharp. And then we're going to go to D sharp, G sharp, B. And we're going to stay on D sharp, G sharp, B. And then we'll move down to C sharp, F sharp, A sharp. Now the fingering for that, I would just go maybe 1, 2, 4, and then 1, 3, 5, 1, 3, 5, 1, 2, 4, or, you know, something close to that. Now you hear this bass thing, E, 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 B, 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 G sharp, G sharp, G sharp, G sharp, F sharp, F. So you hit it five times. It's four counts, but you'll actually play it five times. 1, 2, 3. And what you can do is you can play the right hand and then let this octave left hand do the thum, thum, the little bass electronic sound. And let the pedal, don't hold the pedal down, let it have staccato. And then later you can put the right hand with it a little bit differently for. But you can let the left hand have the prominence so that it sounds like the original. Okay? Because that's what we're going for. We want it to sound as much like the original album version as we can. So if we did it this way, you may like that. You play both hands the five times on each one. All right, so just have fun with that. There's, you know, little different variations you can do with that. Now you have another part later. It goes. That's just, if you want to try this part, you know, that gets close. We have E and B. 1, 2, 3. I put 5 there because it's a fifth. It's not a full chord. We're just doing E and B. Alright, so an E5. Then a B5 would be B and F sharp. And then a G-sharp 5 would be G-sharp, D-sharp. And then an F-sharp 5 would be F-sharp, C-sharp. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3. And then the right hand. Now I know it goes. But you guys really want to do that. If you want to do that, put all of that in there, you can do it. But if you want to simplify a little bit to make it a little easier to play, 1, 2, 3. Okay, if you were my student in my home, I wouldn't expect you to do that. If you're, you know, a beginner, intermediate piano player, I would just do the G sharp 3 times so you get the feel of it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Actually, 4, I guess. And then C sharp, B, G sharp. 1, 2, 3, 4. Da da da. And then we do it again. Da da da. I'm a little dotted lines, ellipsis there, just showing you keep playing the G sharp. If you want to go do all of that, you can, but I'm just going to do it simply. Let's do it here. 1, 2, 3. Go fast. Now, if you want to add a D sharp in there with it too, that even makes it a little more interesting, you know, beyond that. Let me do it real slow if I can. Let's see. This is enough for you to enjoy this song and to learn it. Please subscribe, comment, and like. That's why I'm putting these pop songs up for you youngsters, because you know, so I can get views and stuff, likes and comments. So if you like the pop songs, then do that for me, and I'll keep putting up new, posting new pop stuff for you. So hope you enjoy it, and I'll talk to you later.